This is New High Rollers, pilot number one, VTR 21378. It's 1978. It's the new High Rollers. And here's the man with the action, Alex Trebek.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the brand new High Rollers. We play our game with numbers and a pair of dice. Dice that can be just as exciting, but yes, just as treacherous as you would find in any casino anywhere in the world. But on this new edition of High Rollers, the stakes are going to be higher than ever before, with thousands of dollars in prizes riding on every throw of these dice. So let's go over here to where the action is and join our players.
And our current champion is a singing waitress from West Los Angeles. Her name is Janice Hart. And our challenger, he's his lumber supplier and father of one from Camarillo, Jerry Edwards.
Good to have both of you here.
How are you, Alex?
I am well today, and I hope you are also. Janice Hart, ladies and gentlemen, is our returning champion. On our last program, she won cash and prizes totaling $3,850, including a beautiful emerald and diamond ring. Look at that. Show that to the folks. Isn't that nice? Don't you just love it?
Yes.
And you can continue as our champion if you defeat Jerry. And you're the father of one boy or girl?
Girl.
Girl. How old?
16.
16. I hope she's watching today, and I hope you give her lots to cheer about. Okay.
Try.
As we start this first game, I want you to take a look at the prizes we have up for grabs. In column A, we have a trip to Paris, his and her mopeds, and a complete kitchen. Now, the value of column A is $6,393. Column B, we have a collection of gold coins, and those coins are worth $2,200. And in column C, we've got the big screen television and 1,000 gallons of gasoline, and the value of column C is $3,245. And that means we've got over $11,000 in prizes in this game. Now we're going to take a look at the board to find out how the numbers come up. Here they are. There they are, and if you look at column B, you'll see we have a 7, a 3, and a 1. And that means by adding all three numbers, you come up with a total of 11. So a roll of 11 would help you clear that column and would earn you the gold coins on your side. Now, as you know, in order to win the prizes, you've got to be the player that knocks out the last number in a column. Then you have to go on and win the game. You all set to go? Good luck to you then. Here's your first question. Is it in the Everglades, the Great Lakes, or the Pacific Northwest that the creature known as Bigfoot
Pacific Northwest
can be found? Jerry Edwards is absolutely right. The first roll of this match is yours, Jerry. Here are the dice. Go ahead.
Good.
If you come up with an 11, you're going to be a very happy man.
Get there.
Oh, nine. You missed it. You got a 9. All right, we cannot clear a column with that roll, but you tell me, how do you want to play the 9?
I'll take the 9.
The 9 by itself from column A. That comes off. We go on to this question. Has it been more or less than 5 years since the Beatles broke up?
It's been more.
More, yes. 8 years, to be very specific. Nice going, Janice. You get the dice, and you're free to roll because everything is good. But now if you roll a 12, you'll be able to clear column A with the 4 and 8. And, of course, that 11 will help you clear column B. Go ahead.
Okay. All right, 12.
11 or a 12 would be beautiful. No. Hey, you came up with a double. All right, you get the insurance marker to keep you safe for an extra roll because that was a double 2, and you've got a 4 now. You can take the 4 by itself or the 3-1 combination. What do you want to do?
I'll take the 4.
The 4 comes off. All right, we're left now with an 8 that will clear column A and still the 11 that will clear column B. On President Carter's recent trip, was it in Poland, France, or India? Go ahead, Janice.
It was in France. Oh,
no, wrong answer. The question was that he had so much trouble with his translator, and you had a bit of trouble there,
oh,
and it works to Jerry Edwards' benefit. The right answer, of course, was Poland. You've got control of the dice, Jerry, and they come back on our movable belt to you. Everything is good, and some rolls are going to be better than others. An 8 or an 11 right now would be great for you.
I'll take a roll. Come on, 8. 8, right there.
8 or an 11. 7. Okay, we missed it by 1. Again, we can't clear a column, but how do you want the 7? 7 alone,
I'll
5 and 2.
7 alone.
7 by itself?
7 by itself.
All right, that comes off. We continue. Is it Star Wars or Close Encounters of the Third Kind that stars that cute little robot R2-D2? Jerry.
Star Wars.
Star Wars it is. Right. Yes, indeed. Control of the dice is yours. And again, an automatic roll because everything is possible. Go ahead.
I'll
Let's see if you
dice.
Can get lucky this time.
Nice.
Come up with something that'll clear a column.
Come on. 12. 12.
Ooh, a six. Hey, and again, we can't clear a column. How do you want the six? We can. I'm sorry. The 1-3-2 combination will do it.
Oh, yeah.
That'll clear column B and give you the prize in that column.
I'll take the 1-2-3 combination.
Why not? All right, the 1-2-3 come out. And Jerry Edwards gets the gold coins up on his side of the board. Now, in order to keep those coins, all you have to do is win this game. Is it on Love Boat or Operation Petticoat that Gavin McLeod...
Love Boat.
Love Boat plays the ship's captain. Janice is right. Janice, take a close look at the board. The 5, the 6, the 8 are good rolls, of course, and the 5-6 combination for an 11 would be very nice because that would clear column C. You've got control of the dice and you have that insurance marker. Now, what do you want to do? Do you want to take the roll or do you want Jerry to have it?
Pass it.
Jerry, the dice are coming back to you. You have to come up with one of four rolls. 5, 6, 8, or 11. Those are the only
11.
Good rolls.
8
is a good one. Look at that. That means column A is cleared. And a kitchen, a complete kitchen, the his and her mopeds, and the trip to Paris.
Aww.
Close to $6,400 in prizes going up on your side of the board.
Good.
And we now have two numbers, but three good rolls, a 5, a 6, or an 11 that would give a player column C and the game. Are you Irish, Southern, or drunk? If you speak with a brogue.
Irish.
Irish is right. Yes, Janice gets control of the dice.
Oh, good.
What's it going to be?
I'll pass it. It's all yours, yes, because you're going to lose.
Jerry, you've got the dice, and you need
confidence.
A 5, a 6, or an 11. 11 right now, give you the game and all the prizes we have.
No doubles.
11!
11!
6! Good roll again. Tough man to beat, isn't
yeah.
he?
Really?
Got it going.
Okay, it comes down to this question. Farrah and Lee. Cher and Greg, Liz and Dick. Which Hollywood couple is...
Farrah and Lee!
Still together,
no,
yes,
hey.
You're right. Great anticipation from the champion. What's it going to be?
I'll pass it.
I have to ask you the question, Janice, that's why. All right,
okay.
You need a 5. If you get a 5 this time, then you've won all the prizes and the game and you're leading in the match. A 5 or a double to keep you safe.
Come on, 5.
A 5 or a double.
5.
Oh. No 7, and that means Janice wins the game. Oh, that was a tough one to win for you, Janice. No prizes up on your side of the board. But there were a few prizes on Jerry's side. The gold coins, the kitchen, the mopeds, and the trip to Paris.
Yeah.
Jerry, you just lost over $8,000 in prizes. You know that? Sorry about that, but since those prizes weren't won, they go back into play in this next game. And so, to the kitchen, the mopeds, and the holiday in Paris in column A, we are going to add this prize.
You'll look great and feel even better as you relax in your completely installed jacuzzi whirlpool hot tub. 5 feet in diameter, lots of room for you and the friend of your choice. A hot tub worth $2,250.
And that means that right now, column A's value has increased and it is worth $8,643. To the gold coins in column B, let's add this.
We have a shopping spree on the world's most glamorous street, Rodeo Drive in Beverly Hills. You'll have gift certificates totaling $3,000 to spend any way you like at Van Cleve & Arpels, Ted Lapidus, Giorgio's, and the fabulous Gucci's. A shopping spree of a lifetime on Rodeo Drive.
And to column C, which is already worth over $3,000, here's what we're going to add.
It's a brand new speedboat. It's the 17-foot Ranger runabout, complete with trailer and inboard outboard motor. It's valued at $3,950.
And that makes the total value of Column C $7,195. So we've got over $20,000 in prizes in this game. And remember, you're trying to be the one to knock out the last number in a column and then win the game. Let's see how the numbers come up this time. Looks like column C is the one that can be made with a single roll. The 4, 1, and 3 combination for a roll of 8. All right, Janice, we can't carry insurance markers over from one game to the next, so I'll take that away from you, and we'll start you two off with this question. Iran, Portugal, Cambodia. Which country is ruled by the Shah? Jerry.
Iran.
Iran is right. First roll is yours. Let's see if you can make it a good one.
I'll take it. Come on. 8. 8.
A 6. All right, we cannot clear an entire column. You tell me how you want to make the 6.
I'll take the 6.
The 6 by itself. All right. You have left the 9 and 2 in column A. That means a roll of 11 would be very nice there. And we still have that 3, 1, and 4 for a roll of 8 in column C. Actor Henry Winkler, is he over or under 30?
He's under.
Yes, he's...
under.
No,
oh,
he's just a tad over. He's 31. So Jerry gets the dice, and they are his to roll because every roll is a good one.
I'll take it.
Here we go. 11 would be nice.
11. Come on, 11.
5. All right, we can't do it again. Can't clear a column, but you can take the 4-1, the 2 and 3, or the 5.
I'll take the 5.
Number 5 comes off. All right, fine, let's go on. Anwar, Moshe, Menachem. Which is the first name of the president of Egypt? Jerry.
Anwar.
Anwar. Anwar Sadat. That is absolutely right. Once again, everything is good. I want to point out something to you before you take this roll, Jerry, something you may or may not have noticed. A roll of 11, of course, will clear column A, the 9 and 2 combination, and a roll of 8 will clear column C. But a roll of 10, the 3, 1, 4 from column C and the 2 from column A would give you that also. So you got to look for that one. 8, a 10, or an 11. 3 excellent rolls for you. Go ahead now.
11.
A 10. That's beauty. There it is. The 2, 3, 1, and 4, giving you all the prizes in column C.
I will take the 2, 3, 1, and 4.
I thought you might. All right, $7,195 in prizes going up on your side of the board. Ooh, nice going. Is it Richard Boone or Pat Boone, whose daughter Debbie...
Pat.
Pat Boone sings that hit song, You Light Up My Life. Janice, you're back in this.
Oh, God.
He's getting me right.
7, 8, and 9 are the only good rolls. You have control of the dice.
Okay, I'll pass it.
And the pass is to Jerry, so the dice are coming back, and you've got to roll them again, but this time under a little more pressure.
6.
9.
7, 8, or 9. No more. Janice wins the game and the match. Congratulations. Janice, nice going.
Thanks.
Again, you had no prizes on your side of the board. Jerry had accumulated all of the goodies over there. And this time, he had the big screen TV, that beautiful boat, and 1,000 gallons of gas, over $7,000. And you weren't able to come through with control of the dice at the right moment. We've got good parting gifts for you backstage, and it was a pleasure having you with us, Jerry. Yeah. Goodbye. Jerry Edwards. Well, we've got good news and bad news, I suppose, for Janice Hart here, who's our champion. The bad news is she didn't win any prizes at all in those two games. But the good news is that in just a few moments, you get to play the big numbers, and maybe you'll win $10,000 in cash. Hope she does. We're going to take a break for a commercial message, and then we'll return on High Rollers. Janice Hart is our champion. She has just won two games. She started out with $3,850 in cash and merchandise and didn't win anything in that game. But because you got the match, we're going to give you a brand new RCA 19-inch color television set to push you over the $4,000 mark. And hopefully give you lots of luck going into the big numbers. Now, you know what happens here? You've got to knock all 9 numbers off the board. For each one you get off, we pay you $100 in cash. If you get all of them off, then you win $10,000. And to help you along the way, we have these insurance markers each and every time you roll a double. Good luck to you.
All right.
Take a roll.
Thank you. Okay, here we go.
First roll is going to be a... Ooh, it's almost a double three, but it's an eight. How do you want to play it?
I'll take the eight.
The eight by
the
itself.
Eight off.
Okay, you've got $100.
Hey.
Roll again. Come on, Janice.
All righty, here we go. Come on now.
Hey, doubles. First doubles, that's good news for you. Here's the insurance marker. Now I hear some people yelling 7-5. There are other ways. There's the 9-3. What do you want to do?
7-5.
All right. She has, following the lead of some people in our audience who are yelling for the 7-5. You've got the marker, though, and you're in pretty good shape. Roll again.
All righty. Here we go.
Here we go. Ooh.
Eight.
The roll is an eight. All right, you can take the 6-2, the 4-3-1.
The 6-2.
6-2 combination. All right,
six,
that's
two.
Leaving her with 3-4-9, and there's some good combinations there.
Man.
The 5, the 7, the 8 will be good. A 10 is good. 12, lots of good rolls, and you've got that marker, so come on.
All right.
Let's see if you can make a payoff right here.
Come on now, 9. Oh.
A 6.
Six.
Ooh, can't make a 6. Give me the insurance marker. We'll give you another roll right now and see if you can pick up some more money. You've got $500 to this point, and the roll is a 5. 4-1 combination. The 4-1 coming off. Roll a 12 and win $10,000.
Come on, 12.
12 for 10,000.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Somebody in the audience just yelled, no roll. You bruised my die, but it doesn't matter. Take him again. That may bring you some good luck.
Okay.
12.
12. 7.
Oh, can't make the 7, but you picked up $700, and that means you now have $5,150 in prizes. Nice going.
Thank you.
Now, you weren't able to go all the way. Pick up the $10,000 here, but that's all right. We still have all those prizes from the previous game still up there for grabs. We've got over $20,000, and we're going to add to that right after we meet our new contestant. Who is it, Kenny?
Our new challenger is a Canoga Park auto salesman, the father of two, and his name is Bob Schultz.
Bob, welcome. Hi, Bob.
Good to have you here. Hi. Good.
You all set to do it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's concentrate on the prize board and see what we're going to add to column A.
Fluffy and Furry is Davidi's very own individually designed stroller-length jacket of natural Canadian red fox, furnished by Dicker and Dicker of Beverly Hills and valued at $2,500.
And look what it does to the value of column A. It's now worth $11,143. What are we going to put in column B?
You and our guests are off on a 15-day visit to the Pearl of the Orient, fabulous Hong Kong. Shopping and sightseeing by day, dining in Oriental splendor by night. An unforgettable prize from the new high rollers worth $2,450.
And that makes the value of column B right now $7,650. And to the three prizes in column C, here's what we add.
You'll always be in touch with the world with this telephone that travels anywhere. And it travels in style, installed in this brand new T-top Mustang. Car and phone are valued at over $7,300.
And the value of column C, $14,495. $14,000. So we've got about $30,000 in prizes, and here are the numbers that are going to help you win those prizes. Column A looks like the column right now that could be wrapped up with just one roll. Roll of 9 would give you all those prizes. All right, here we go. First question, McLean Stevenson, Alan Alda, Wayne Rogers, Janice.
Mash.
That wasn't the question.
Sorry.
Which one is still a regular on MASH? And the right answer is Alan Alda. So Bob Schultz gets the first roll of this game. Go ahead, Bob.
Come on, man. Get on it.
Oh, you got a 10, and it's a double. Here's the insurance marker for the double, first of all, to keep you safe. Now, you can take the 1, 2, 3, and 4 combination.
I think I'll take the 1, 2, 3, 4 combination.
All right, those four numbers coming up, and five prizes worth $11,143. Over to Bob Schultz's side of the board. Dustin Hoffman, Richard Dreyfuss, or Al Pacino? Which one played Robert Redford's partner? Janice?
Robert Redford, Al Pacino, I don't know.
You said everything but the right answer, which was Dustin Hoffman. Bob Schultz, you get control of the dice. The numbers that are on the board are good rolls, and the 5, 6, 5, 7 combinations of 11 and 12 are good also. What are you going to do?
Pass.
You're going to pass. All right, you had an insurance marker. Janice, it's up to you to come up with one of those good rolls. Take the dice, and let's see if you can make some good things happen.
All right. Come on now.
Roll is a 7, okay. Which is good. 7 is good. You can't clear a column, but you stay alive. Lillian, Amy, or Rosalind? Which one is Jimmy Carter's mother?
Lillian.
Lillian is Jimmy Carter's mother. Yay! Yes, indeed. Janice, you've got control of these dice. He's got an insurance marker. Those are good rolls, the numbers that are lit on the board, and the 11 also. What are you going to do?
I think I'll pass it to Bob.
Bob, the dice are yours to roll. Look at it this way. You roll a 6 right now or an 11, and you will add all of the prizes in column C to what you've already got up there. Go ahead.
Oh, be good, man. Oh, keep good. Be good, be good, be good, be good. All right.
6. Look at that. I think the time has come, Bob, for us to give these dice a saliva test, because you've just added $14,495 in prizes to your side of the board. I don't want to put any undue pressure on you, Bob, but this game right now is worth about $25,000 to you. Listen carefully. She was Al Pacino's sister in The Godfather.
Talia Shire
is right. You've got control of the dice.
All right, I'll pass it to Bob.
5, 9, and 8 are the only good rolls. But you've got that insurance marker.
I'm going to.
You're not going to clear a column, but you've got to stay alive in the game. Go ahead.
Here we go.
5, 9, 8. 10.
10 is no good. I'll take the insurance marker. You have to keep rolling. We ask you to roll again. You need a 5. A 9 or an 8?
9! Give me a 9!
Oh, seven. Janice wins again! Janice, there was nothing up on your side of the board, but Kenny, I'd like you to tell Bob all the prizes he is not going to be going home with today. He had 9 of them up there, $25,000 worth. That's the bad news for you, Bob. The good news, there is good news, always good news on High Rollers. You do have another chance, because all of those prizes go back on the board. And so the 5 prizes that you missed out on in column A go back up there. That's the maximum number of prizes we put in a column. So right now, we are going to add $1,000 in cash to column A to raise its value to $12,143. Column B. To those 3 prizes, here is what we're going to add.
You'll be able to look at your own appearance on the new High Rollers with this exciting new Sony Betamax videotape recorder. Record your favorite programs, watch them when you please, just as easily as this.
$500. What's another way of saying sidewalk surfing? What's another way of saying sidewalk surfing?
It's a prize worth $2,400.
And it brings column B to a value of $12,730. Now we've got 4 prizes already in column C. We're going to add 1 more to bring it to its maximum. Here it is.
It's a fabulous French kitchen, a complete collection of imported copper cookware, and the great food machine from France, the Cuisinart, everything you need to make your kitchen your favorite room. It's a prize from the new High Rollers worth $2,424.
And value now of column C is $16,000. And just off the top of my head, it looks like we're talking about $40,000. $40,000 in prizes at the sound of the bell. That means we have to take a break. We will do that and come back to wrap things up in just a moment. Our champion, ladies and gentlemen, is Janice Hart, a singing waitress from Los Angeles. And when she leaves High Rollers today, she is going to have an armed escort. Not to protect her and the prizes she has won on the show, but to protect her because of the over $40,000 in prizes she has prevented her two male opponents from winning. I know how I would feel if she had done that to me, but the good news, of course, is that those $40,000 in prizes plus some extras are going to be in competition in our next game when we come back. And so until then, this is Alex Trebek thanking you two players and you two, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us. Until we meet again, so long and have a good day.
This has been a Merrill Eater Buzz McGee production.
If you like this, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more. And check out my Facebook page for other exciting content.